Stephen Hawking is known as one of the world's biggest geniuses. The English physicist is also responsible for predicting many of the world's major events. And he even came up with massive theories, for example, the general relativity theory and the theory of black holes. Of course, all of these theories were proved true, and he's one of the smartest men to ever live. But sadly, in 2018, he passed away. He was known for having ALS, which left him paralyzed in a wheelchair. The average life expectancy for those who have that disease is a few years, but he broke all records and lived for 50 years after being diagnosed. But as the year 2020 rolls around, we should think back to Stephen Hawking and some of the things he said before he passed away. In fact, he left us some major warnings going into this next decade. And seeing as we'll be in that decade in about a month, let's go through some of his major warnings and predictions. I'm Charlie, and today we're going to look at Stephen Hawking's warning for 2020. But before we get hit by a meteorite, why not subscribe and press the notification bell too? Coming up first, we have leaving Earth. One major warning Stephen Hawking said is that humans are putting all of their eggs in one basket. This is basically a metaphor saying everything we've ever built is on one planet, Earth. And for around 50 years, Stephen Hawking had been calling for humans to move onto another planet. Every time he said it, it made headlines and they said it's totally impossible. But now let's look at what's happening with Elon Musk and SpaceX. SpaceX, in cooperation with NASA, are now taking us to Mars. SpaceX already has reusable rockets to get humans and materials back and forth from Mars. But Hawking said that mankind would soon fall victim to many, many catastrophes on Earth. He said there are lots of what he calls low probability, high impact events. This will include things like large asteroids hitting our planet and wiping us out. The probability of this is low, but it would be catastrophic if it did happen. Just imagine an asteroid hitting a nuclear missile or a power plant. It could easily destroy a whole continent, a whole planet, or the entire world. And because asteroids are so unpredictable, scientists could not warn us in time to save the world. So he said it's essential that we move off Earth and diversify on other planets, such as Mars. In 2016, he said, although the chance of disaster to planet Earth is quite low, it adds up over time. And he said it becomes nearly certain in the next 1,000 years or so. He warned that humans must spread out onto other planets. So all I have to say to that is, hurry up, Elon! Next up is space signals. You may not have heard of this, but there's a whole field of science known as SETI. SETI stands for the Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence. And there are many giant satellites which act as listening devices all around the world to listen out for ETs. This could be a signal from an intelligent life being elsewhere in the universe or in a different universe. But Stephen Hawking warned against reaching out to any alien life. You may think that a science nerd like Hawking would be into contacting aliens. But he left a warning for scientists saying do not try and contact any alien civilizations. He said all that would likely happen is aliens would raid Earth and then move on to another planet. They would likely be so much more smart than us that they wouldn't care to talk to us at all. It would be like how we see ants or small insects. Think about it, when you step on a snail by accident, you go, oh well. And that's exactly what aliens would do. It would be like a human taking honey from a beehive. He even said that if aliens visit us, it would be like when Columbus landed in America. As we all know, that did not turn out well for the Native Americans. He said it is sad, but he left a warning saying do not contact intelligent alien life. And if any SETI researchers do get any intelligent signals, we should not reach out, but instead be very, very fearful. Next up, we have robots. We've all seen old movies like The Terminator where robots take over the planet and wipe out humanity. But truth may be stranger than fiction, and that could be reality according to Stephen Hawking. He said that artificial intelligence would give us great advances, but also dangers. In fact, in 2014, he said the development of full AI could end the human race. He said the primitive forms of AI we have right now are very useful indeed. But he left a warning saying don't let machine intelligence match or surpass humans. Otherwise, they would have no need for us and would work on wiping us out. Fellow genius Elon Musk has said the exact same thing. Already we're seeing AI take people's jobs, which presidential candidate Andrew Yang has made a big deal about. But Stephen Hawking said if we want any future for humanity, we must keep a close eye on AI. Next up, we have media and politics. Stephen Hawking is a scientific genius, but that doesn't mean he doesn't have great insights when it comes to things like the media and political life on Earth. He warned that the world will get more and more divided as time goes on. Amazingly, he said this before major world events, for example the 2016 US elections and Brexit. It does seem like people are getting more and more pulled apart and divided. Stephen Hawking also said he fears isolationism. He says, as far as science goes, it's critical that countries work together. If countries don't work together, then AI may crop up in one country more than another and it can't be regulated on a global level. Stephen Hawking also warned of politicians investing more money into nuclear weapons. He actually campaigned for nuclear disarmament worldwide and said nuclear weapons are a terrible creation. Sadly, pretty much no one listened, and almost every country in the world is making nuclear weapons as we speak. But who knows, maybe soon politicians will wake up and listen to this genius. That is, before it's too late. Next up, we have climate change. Stephen Hawking was very concerned about global warming, and he said it's a big threat to life on the planet Earth. He said this is one of the main reasons why we need to go to another planet, for example Mars. But his biggest fear was us passing what's known as the tipping point. The tipping point is where global warming will become irreversible. He said he feared Earth becoming like Venus, where the temperature is 250 degrees Celsius. And the rain there is sulfuric acid, meaning no life can survive. However, Stephen Hawking said all of this must be done on a government level. He said people don't need to stop flying in aeroplanes or driving their cars to work, but instead, governments need to come together and make sure they use renewable energies. Elon Musk and Bill Gates, for example, have invested billions into solar-powered energy. And seeing as this energy already exists, we don't really need to use coal or nuclear energy, which really harms the Earth. He said global warming is one of the great dangers humanity faces, but we can prevent it if we act now. And finally on the list, we have far future. So all of these things I've just gone over were his warnings for 2020, which is the immediate future. But what about in the far future, like hundreds or thousands of years away? Well, I've got bad news for you. He said that in about 1 billion years, the sun's current phase of development will swell into a gigantic red ball. This would likely scorch or swallow Earth. And as the sun grows hotter and hotter, Earth may be too hot for human life. But when will the entire universe end? Well, it said that in 10 trillion years, the universe will end. And it will apparently end from heat. An increase in heat could end the entire universe. It would diminish into a state of no thermodynamic free energy, and it would no longer be able to sustain directed motion or any life at all. But luckily, we'll all be long gone before that happens. Even so, it is pretty creepy to think that one day all of this will no longer exist. That is unless we live in a multiverse and humanity can get to another universe. But now it's time to make your opinion heard. Vote in the poll in the top right corner, which of Stephen Hawking's warnings was the most scary? If you want some more amazing videos, then check out my second channel. There'll be a link to that on screen in a moment. But as always, thanks for watching. Check out some more videos on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.